Position of my phone holder so that when I travel, it'll be in a better position. I'm thinking it might not bounce as much, but I know I'm going to get a better view up here. This is an IOTI, and I'm going to get another one. I'm going to Target now, and I'm still going to have one that I want to put here. For a different view. Hey everyone, I gotta go into Target, so I better get my scarf ready. You can watch me do this. I like these scarves better. I have it ready to go when I put it down. When I get there, I'll put it up. Okay, so we're gonna go to Target. While I'm waiting for Target to open up, a few minutes, what do I like about cooler weather? A lot. And whatever you like, leave me a comment. One thing I enjoy about the cooler weather is the fact that I can park in the sun and I can power up my power banks using my solar on my roof. And my minivan won't heat up to 106 degrees like it does in the summer. Another thing I like about the cooler weather is wearing sweaters again. You know, I mean, bundling up in clothes, and it reminds me of my childhood. I grew up in northern Ohio near Port Clinton. And I was used to the cooler weather. I was born and raised there. I left when I was about 22, 23 years old. And then at night and in the morning I can snuggle in my blankets. I don't know how many nights in the summer that I slept in here. Well, obviously I did sleep in here, and I couldn't even put a sheet over me. It was warm. Even though I had the fan going, I still could not, and on some mornings and nights I couldn't even have a sheet on me. So it's kind of nice to snuggle up again. No more chasing shady spots to park my minivan. Oh, I'm so thrilled about that. It's okay. If I park in a shady spot, it's okay. But I don't have to do that. So that's great. And it reminds me that the holidays are coming. I mean, especially Thanksgiving's right around the corner. And also, oh my God, beautiful landscapes. The reds and the yellows and the oranges. Oh, so beautiful. So that's what I like about the cooler weather. I think I see people going in, so we'll go in and we'll go look and see if I can find another one of these holders. This is the kind I'm looking for. $24.99. This is what I have. I'm just gonna have two of them. I'm gonna put this here. I have the other, my older one, I put on the actual windshield. So let's open this up. Okay. Oh, fuck. I don't need this plate because I can still use this one. Well, let's see this. Oops. Oopsie. Okay. Goes in there, I do believe. Then, there we go. Now it's straight. There we go. Righty tighty. Okay. There. See, it extends out. It goes here. And then this. Loosen this up. So there's. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put it on this way. Here's the tab. I'm going to take that off. Oh, dear. And it's very sticky, so I won't touch it. But I will tell you that would... Hi! I'm leaning into my car. When you want to move these, all you do, you have to lift up the tab, and then it's really hard. You have to really pull. But if you take warm water and you wipe it, kind of rub it, oops, and then what you do is you rub it and then let it dry. You can just stick it anywhere again. So, yeah, here we go. This on straight, and then you push this down for the suction. There we go. See, now this can go in, out, and this is for this. I'm thinking right there is good. The reason I have this one up here, as I mentioned, is it's gonna be better for filming landscape. Here, my tennis. Hi. Kind of having a bad hair day today. Who cares? For lands. Whoa. Chill out. Yeah. So I can get better landscape, and I think it won't shake as much up here. We'll see. Let me comment on a couple of your comments. So, Yunsum Kim, you had mentioned that you appreciated me explaining my bed situation because it reminded you of when you were in Korea and you had to roll out your bed, and then in the morning you rolled it back up. Thank you for that. I'm glad to, kind of kick in a childhood memory. I like it too. I mean, even in the Bible, Jesus said, take up your bed and walk, you know. So I think they kind of walked around with their bed rolls. And if you remember Kung Fu, remember the show Kung Fu? Kwai Chang Kane, I love that show. And he had his bed roll. He had it on it like a rope, and he had it around. He carried it on his back, sort of like a sling. So yeah, well... thank you for that comment. I appreciate you very much. Let's see, another one, Donna K. You're in Illinois. Yeah, stay warm. Oh, you guys are really going to get cold. Oh, my gosh. And then all that jazz. You had said, oh, I would kill to be at 48 degrees. I failed to mention to you and to all of you, it seems to be an ongoing situation. Whatever the temperature is outside, it's usually about 10 to 12 degrees warmer in here. So outside, it was probably about 35, 36 degrees outside. It was 48 in here because I've got my body temperature warming up things just a little bit. So if it's 32 degrees in here, yeah, it's going to be below freezing outside. Cat C. I'm so sorry about your son's death, and I'm so sorry about that, and I just wanted to say hey, and my heart and prayers are going out to you. And anybody else who read that comment from you that came to my channel, I'm sure they're saying a prayer for you too. So, love you. Patricia Ellis, that said that when that you're all snuggled in your blanket while I'm snuggled in mine and we're spending time together having coffee. That's great. Love you.
Here.
Okay. To keep going, Felicity Calf. You said Mechanics 101 on that one video. Yes, definitely. I mean, Mechanics 101 is pretty good. You just need to, I think it's a good idea for everybody to at least know a little bit about their vehicles if we're females. And I know a lot of you do, so yeah. And then UCLA, yes, you can play my videos at 2x the speed. And I think I still get credit for it. Ha ha. I'm going to have to try that. And then Julie Cooper, you asked about a roof rack. I don't have a roof rack. I've mentioned in the past that I don't really want a roof rack because of the wind resistance and the fact that it makes it just a little bit less stealthy. But you know what? I change on a dime. It's okay. I might end up getting one, you know? I don't know.
Whoa.
I'm just testing out my new tripod. Help, I'm falling. We had a change of plans. I went outside and I was gonna walk around. I got dressed. The wind is blowing and it's freezing. So, make coffee for you and me, or tea. If you like tea, it's tea for you. There you go. Enjoy. Cheers. Oh yeah, my second cup. It's about 10:30 in the morning. I got up so early. I woke up and couldn't go back to sleep. So I kind of laid there for a couple hours. Literally, I laid there for a couple hours. And then finally, the alarm went off and I got up. It's really cold outside. It really is cold. Let's see if I can show you. Very cloudy. Well, I got all my stuff on here. It's a nice little dresser. You know how we put our things on our dressers when we have homes. So, my little dresser. This is fake, but it's kind of cool. I think I got this at Target. Yeah. And then I do have a candle. It's like ginger cookies or something like that for. Now this I bought, this is like one of those silicone ice cube trays. I just cut all the sections out. I thought it'd be perfect. It won't slide. It's the right color. Hello. It's the right color. And I can just put little things in it. One thing, like little bobby pins and little Tic Tacs. Matches for my candle. For my lights. Yeah. And of course, the Bobbsey twins. I still have these. Let's check them out. Let's see how they're progressing. Yeah. It almost looks like a, let's see if we can get it. It almost looks like a piece of like a caramel candy. Kind of. There it is. There it is. I know, it's all concave. And then the twin. Let me see if I can hold this right. It looks like a little piece of candy or something. You know how the caramel, the chocolate kind of goes over? We'll set these out. Okay, my little pets. Yeah. Okay, so, speaking of pets, I'm going to answer some questions. Let's see. Let me get my coffee ready. Questions. Question number one, Deanne Rothbard, have I ever felt unsafe on the road? Yes, I have. It was just recently, too. I felt totally unsafe. And I put a few of my, I won't mention what they are, but I put a few of my weapons around. I went to a truck stop and I parked. And I forgot to, my water's way deep in there, so I have to kind of go around my van to get on the other passenger side to get it. I have to go outside. And I forgot my thing, and I went out of my van, and oh my gosh, it was parked beside me, and he got out right at the right time, and he just like, whoa, he's like, whoa, and he just started talking, and something told me to just be nice. He was a younger guy than I was. He may be maybe like 42, 43 years old. But he started complimenting me on my looks and things like that. And I go, oh, no, I'm not interested. He goes, let's go have coffee. And so I stood there and I talked to him for a while. I was trying to feel him out. Basically, should I move? He started talking about politics and stuff. And we were on the same side on that. But other than that, I felt unsafe. The Holy Spirit was like, be on guard. Be on guard. So I was on guard. I was very nice. And yeah, that was one of the first times that I felt, OMG, this could be, he could be a problem, you know, and it could be a girl too. I found that sometimes in some ways, girls have become kind of vicious also. So, they always were, but I think even more so now, kind of revealing some of their true colors. Okay. So Jill Weatherly, do I have a fire extinguisher? Yes, I do. And I keep it right here. It's right here in this little bin. And it's right here. I keep that there. I got it from Amazon, so it's in my links. You can find it. It's under the cooking. Yeah. So I recommend this. I should do this. This is my tryout for commercials, doing commercials. Yeah. It came in a two-pack. But I don't need two packs. This is full. I've never used it. Thank goodness. I've never used it. And I don't need two of them. And so I gave one away. Because if you have something in your car and it's doubled up, what if everything was doubled? You know, so you can only carry so much. I don't like to carry what I don't need. And it came in a two pack and I thought I would need two pack, but yeah, I don't. Thank goodness I don't. Is Chlorstade. Where do you buy propane and butane? You can buy them at Walmart's, Target's, I believe, too. The green propane tanks last longer and is really about the same price, I believe. It's hard to find the butane now because it's easier to use and it goes so fast. I mean, if it's on the shelves, it usually is gone within an hour, I imagine. If I found some on the shelves at Walmart, it's usually because they put it out just recently. I do believe that Big Five, I went to Big Five one time when I was in Vegas. Because I went to REI, they didn't have any. I went to Walmart, and I said, well, I don't know. They said, well, we think Big Five carries it, too. They had a bunch at Big Five. So I usually have a lot of the butanes handy. But also, that's one of the reasons I got the dual stove, is so that if I do run out of butane, I can always use propane. No, you do not reuse the green propane tanks. You just throw them away. Awake Kate, my sunglasses, yes. I wear an array of sunglasses. And I buy them everywhere. I mean, I just, you know, when I think about it, I look around. If I see sunglasses, I go, oh, let me go look at their sunglasses. Target, the mall, anywhere. Anywhere that you see some unusual sunglasses, you can go online and find some cool sunglasses also. Okay. I've even looked for my sleeping pad at REI, and this is for Gail Johnson. And I have not found the one that I have online. I think it was just luck of the draw that I walked into the store and they had what I wanted. So that's why I mentioned on the comments, you're going to have to just go in or just go online and see what they have. I can't find mine. And I usually don't do links unless they are from Amazon, because they're so much easier to order. As far as my wool blankets go, I've had those for years. I've had quite a few of them, and I've given them to my kids. And I just came across, somebody had a whole bunch of red wool blankets that they didn't need anymore. And so I said, oh yeah, I'll take them. And gave some away, and I had two left, and I brought them with me. Now, as far as my hiking shoes, my Vosk, Zappos. You're just going to have to go on Zappos and look for hiking shoes. You can look for Vosk. Or with Zappos, it's so cool because you can actually put in what you want. See, do you want only show wide, only show size 8, only show this brand, only show like below $100, things like that. So you can click in what you want and they'll show you what they want. Zappos is super. And they have free returns. You just, if you don't like it, you return it. And then you just tell them you want a size bigger or smaller. Burning up the roads. The Amazon links. How often do I have people using my links and ordering things? Well, you're doing it pretty often. I don't know how often, but it shows like how what people are purchasing. You're doing a lot of fairy lights. People are doing fairy lights, yes. But it doesn't really show how often. And I appreciate you. Yeah. Linda loves wild horses in Nevada, northern Nevada. Oh, yeah. I went with Red and Dennis to Carson City. Now, Dennis told a story of him and his wife witnessed a herd pushing out a young male horse. They're Mustangs. All over. Sometimes you can look up in the mountains and you see this cloud of dust. It's a herd of Mustangs, you know, on the mountains. Really cool. But then what happens is the young males, they sort of wander around and they feed off grass, and they're very protected here. And people appreciate them. So they don't get too close to them, and they don't, people don't harm them. They just kind of stay out of their way. And but eventually the horses will gather up their own herds, and the males will establish, you know, their own family. Yeah. Stephanie, have I ever considered a pet? Yes, I have. I wouldn't mind it. Yeah, that would be fun to have a little dog in here. Oh, yeah. You know what, though? It would have to be a very small dog, a very small dog. And I don't want one, well, like Sappo. I mean, I do like Sappo. I would want one even a little bit smaller than Sappo. But Sappo's Chihuahua. I found like Chihuahuas, they really do bark a lot. And I wouldn't want one to bark all the time. Just a small dog. And, but I don't know. I mean, I don't take anything off the table because, I mean, I change my mind. I'm fluid just like anybody else. My thoughts and my ideas are very fluid in life, and I'll go here and I'll go there and I'll decide, well, now it's time. You know, sometimes it's the right time. I swear it looked like I was looking out the window. I was like, is that snow? I believe it. If it was going to rain, I believe it could snow a little bit today. Oh my gosh. Okay. Joanne Sheets, hey, girlfriend. Yes, Carson City was really, really cool. And, you know, I'll go again before I leave. I might leave Wednesday. You know, like I said, everything is fluid. I might leave Wednesday and I might not. I might go down to Lake Havasu, and I might not. That's all I got to say about that. That's right. Kara's life on the farm. Kara's life on the farm. You are spending some time because you're on a farm. You can't leave. I mean, you have animals. I totally understand that. When I was younger, and my husband came back from, we lived in Germany for a couple years, and when he came back from Germany, at that time, he really didn't know what he wanted to do. And there, somebody had alerted him to this one job that was out. It was a small town, but it was out. And it was working on a farm. Oh, they offered us a house and everything. That was so fun. That was the first that we had ever lived on a farm. And, you know, I helped with the chickens and things like that. And so we know about farm life. And no, you can't leave. The cows need to be milked every single day. Yes, they do. Every morning and then at night again. And the chickens have, I totally understand. But you did say that you spend here and there time in your minivan that you have fixed up. And I advocate that. I talk about that probably more on my podcast now, that not only do I encourage and instruct people how to live full time in their minivans, but to use them as a camper van also. I mean, you can save so much money on traveling. And, you know, I love my little clubhouse. You know, I think of it like, sometimes I am like this, I don't know, little girl sometimes. I still am. And I think of this as like my little clubhouse in here. I mean, that's why I kind of like to have it fixed up and make it look nice. Okay. Straighten this up. Now you can see outside. I just love you guys and I love your questions. And I just thought I'd spend today. I was going to walk around and give you some better scenery, but it's really cold out there. I swear, it's going to snow. It looks like, it does, it looks like snow is coming in. Eeks. Cheers. So good. This is fun. I hope you're having fun. More questions. Sadie Hasco, you had mentioned about hiking alone, and that maybe one of the reasons that haven't been out is because, I didn't have somebody to go with. Well, that's not entirely true, but as far as going to the waterfalls, that was kind of a hike up. I never would have found that on my own. So yeah, in a way, yes. Thank you for realizing that. And I feel like you know, many of you, especially you, we're kind of getting to know each other. You kind of know me a little bit, and maybe you're figuring out like why I do this or why I do that, and that's kind of fun for me. And hopefully someday I'm going to get to know some of you also. And we find out, you know, like what you like and things like that. Chad too. Love you. Love your channel. you had mentioned silicone wiper blades. Thank you for reminding me of that. I forgot about the silicone. Yes. The next time I get new wiper blades, oh yeah, I know they're probably going to be more expensive, but that's okay. They're already expensive. But what I did was, with the main wiper, the one that's on the driver's side, you can turn them around so you're using the other side of the blade. And that's what I did this time. Next time, thank you for reminding me. And anybody that wants to check out ChadTube channel, yeah. Three generations. You talked again about the cabin filter. Hey, I don't know about it. A car would have to be really old to not have a cabin filter, I would think. I'm sure within the last 15 years, there's cabin filters. I wouldn't delay at checking them out. You need to go online, type in make, model, year, and type in cabin filter. Where is it? How to get to it? Or go on YouTube and it will show you. They're usually, I think they all are. They're in behind the glove compartment. And if you go on the YouTube, it will show you how to bring down, because you have to undo the glove compartment. You have to like push in and then it will drop. Take everything out first and then it'll drop down. But there'll be instructions on it. Check it out. If you don't have a cabin filter, that might be bad, because it means you're sucking in all that. And mine was so dirty. I had one in there, but mine was so filthy. And I had just changed it like a year and a half previously. So in a year and a half, that's one of the reasons I was sneezing and coughing so bad. I forgot about it. So check it out. Yes. Paige Dauphinus, yeah. Oh, the REI. Well, you already meant, I already mentioned the REI. No, I don't give REI links. You're just going to have to go on REI and type it in with what you want. I don't really do REI too much anymore. I mean, I do have a membership, but everything's so expensive there. And since I travel, if I have to order it, I mean, they don't have lockers like Amazon does. Okay, Roaming Roca. You liked my logo. Thank you. Two. V for victory. Or peace. Two apps that I used. First, I went into Sketchbook. And because they have like these little rulers in that you bring them down. And you just make your hand go around like Fritz Circle. And it'll do the circle perfectly. And then there's a ruler where, and then you put the ruler where you want and just put your hand down and it'll go on the side. And then I took it to one of you. I can't find your name, but you know, let me know who you are. You suggested that I use Knockout, that it would put it on a transparency, which it did. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. So, I got questions taken care of, and one of you would ask me about YouTube channels. Well, let me tell you, I think I will go into talking about that more as time goes on. What the heck is that? I know. I'm going to be looking at myself there. I have done videos for years, and I've edited videos for years. And I love playing around with it. I am a self-taught graphic artist. I taught myself when everybody in the mid-90s was getting a personal computer. I kind of liken it to when, right before I was born, not everybody had a TV in their home. I'm serious. That I think a lot of family members that they would go to, like I remember, like I heard that they'd go to my grandpa's house because he had a TV and they'd go watch TV. Well, when I was born, of course, we had a TV. But I think like 5 years previously to when I was born, yeah, there weren't TVs. Well, I kind of liken that time, the personal computer. I was one of the first that said, I must get one of those. I heard about them. I want one. And I started meeting people that had software. I think it was pirated software, but I had all the, somebody gave me a full set of all the Adobes. That's when they were still on the disc. Yeah. Now you have to subscribe monthly, you know, to get things like, to get Adobes and stuff. But I had all the Adobes. Macromedia. Remember Macromedia? And I don't know, are they still there? Everything. I started learning how to do, HTML, it's totally different now. The codes are different, I believe. But, oh, yeah, I want to know how to do a website. I want to know how to do these things. And I used to just spend hours and hours learning all of this. So I was doing videos for a long time. And I know how to edit them. And I understand software because in some ways, a lot of software is very similar. You just have to kind of play around with it. So I've had some of you ask, well, teach us, you know, tell us how to do it. If you are a nomad and you want to have a YouTube channel, I only in will let you know that you had better love editing videos, because you're going to spend a lot of time doing it. It takes hours for me to do these videos. Am I complaining? Mm-mm, because I love it. You have to love it. You just have to love it. And that's why I will continue doing them, and hopefully I'll keep collecting, and like a Rolling Stone, I'll keep collecting, subscribers that want to enjoy, and we can get to know each other. So I will continue doing it because this is what I enjoy doing. And I enjoy, but there's a lot I don't know. And what I'm doing now is on my spare time, I'm going over lighting, position of the camera. That's a whole nother ball game here. Yeah. So if you enjoy editing, if you enjoy photography, and if you enjoy speaking in front of the camera, that's another factor. At first, there was a lot of, and they're still there. But I believe that over the course of time, it's a little bit less and less. Just being real with you guys and being honest, I don't know how many nomads actually talk about this area. Probably a few. But if you really want to have a YouTube and you want to travel, these are things that you have to love. And it can get a little expensive in the fact that you do have to increase on your equipment. Well, the tripod. And, well, I'm about to embark on getting a new iPhone, the 12 Pro. I'm not sure the 12 Pro or the 12 Pro Max. The only difference I can see on the Max is that it has this night vision, which might be cool, but I don't know. But it's like $300 more, so I don't know. Do I really want the night vision? Do I really want it? And then it's just certain things that you need. And you have to come up with ideas. So if you want to do it, I'm going to continue doing it on my iPhone. I am, because the cam that GoPro didn't work out. And I'm not really sure. I'm going to keep looking. Probably over the course of the year, I'll be looking for a camera and maybe asking questions. Maybe when I get to RTR, I can ask some questions of other people. So, well, that's about the YouTube. I just wanted to mention that. Yeah, I mean, it's fun to do YouTube, and it sounds like fun to have one and, connect up with people. But I'm telling you, you better love editing videos, because that's what you're going to do. So I do apologize for this video just being an inside video again. Well, you can see a little bit of a tree out there. It's just too cold today. I'm not going out there too much today. I may not get my walk in today, but It's like a winter day here in Reno. So what I want to do is I want to do some shout outs. Now, if you've already heard your name, I guess you can be excused. You can go now. I know. I'm like the teacher. You're excused. Let me put my teacher glasses on. There you go. I'll put them down here. The librarian. So I want to do some shout outs. If you didn't ask a question, I still want to give you a shout out. And there's quite a few. So once you hear your name, you're excused to go. But, you know, for the sake of the rest of the class, you might want to stay to the end.
I know.
Okay. Ready? Here we go. Debbie Molitor. Gail Johnson. Oh, I mentioned you, but twice for you. Carla White. Joyce Leathers. Love ya. Sarasota Tim. Oh, what can I say? You know, you sent me to a new tripod too. Thank you. Tammy DeBoard. Love you. David Merling. Yeah. You're sticking with me. Jean Goodyear. Oh, I love that name. Sissy's Journey. What can I say? Love ya. Jill Weatherly. Craig Huffman. Oh, Are you feeling good? Because, you know, I'm praying for you. Love you, Craig. And Christos, hello. Lourdes Gonzalez, hi. Jay Galathorn, hey. Sandra Matthews, love ya. Camille Simmons. Token Tina's Travels. Ooh, what you token, girl? Sweet Pea. I love that. Sweet Pea. Lilani Adams. Yes, love you. Stephanie Sturgeon. You always give good comments. Thank you, Stephanie. Louis Vogel. Hey. Teresa Weeks. Denise Johnson. And Denise F. Ooh, what's the F stand for? Misty Spring, that's cute. Erin Lee, Shelly Roberts, and Sisyphus. Okay. Okay, so if you've already heard your name, you can go now. I'm sorry. I'm being goofy. I'm stuck inside. The weather sucks out there. Mitch McGreal. Hey, are you Scottish? McGreal. Joyce Jason, love you. Barbara Spann. Debbie Fiddler, Diane Todd, hey. JCR Bennett, what can I say? I love you, girl. And when I get to Phoenix, and I'm going to, I am going to come see you. So you better be ready. JCR Bennett and my daughter were friends. And JCR Bennett, I don't say her real name, obviously. She went, starts with a J, though. She lived with us for a couple months, and I just loved it. I mentioned to my son the other day, I go, yeah, I go, Jay, her name, I go, she, you know, follows me on Instagram, and she always watches my videos, and he goes, really? He goes, I remember when she was there. Everything, she was so cool. The whole house, she added so much, such a nice vibe to that. I mean, it had a good vibe to it, but it was just fun having her there. It really was. She's so mature. And I remember being in the living room, and I would look through, and I'd walk past the bedroom, and she'd be putting makeup on and stuff. So I'd stop and talk to her. So I'm coming to see you, girl. Nelson CC, love you. Optical X-ray. Ooh, okay. Sadie Haskell. Mm-hmm. Poppy. Hi, Poppy. Trey Ryan. Love ya. Michelle Collins. Love you. Tammy Normal. Are you normal? I asked you that the last time. Okay. It's an old joke. Sorry. Thank you for watching. All of you, thank you for watching. Dreamy Sunshine. Wow. I love that. Carmen McCarver. Are you Scottish too? EDM. Mm-hmm. Rita Jimmy, yes, you comment quite a bit. Thank you. Lori, and that's just Lori. That's all it is. I love you. Cindy Surway. Hey, I got a little bit of the coffee burp. Sorry. I guess I'm keeping it real, real. It's real today. A little bit left. Pamela Van Delden. Ooh. Life by the Sea. Hypnotic Listener, wow. Gypsy Love, Sophia, N My Corner. That's like cute. N, it's not In My Corner, it's N My Corner. I like that. Redeem 7777. You sound cold. Wow. It's like, what did you say? It was like 1 degree or something? Where are you? Let me know where you are. That is so cold. Okay, so if you've heard your name, you're allowed to go. Okay, but there's more. So if you haven't heard your name, hold on. DJ Raiders, hey. Kim Dozier, hello. Yes, Anil. Ooh. Yes, Anil. Yes, Anil. Trillo. I'm not saying that right, but I'm sorry, but I think you know who you are. Love you. Naomi Mortalvo. Oh, that's a cool name. Chad Tubes already. Oh, you get it twice. Hey. Adam Bradbury. Ooh, that's a cool name. Cactus. Thank you. Love you. Julie. Love you too. Leslie Monsell Arts. You sound like you have a regular channel. I got to check it out. I haven't had time, but I'm going to go check it out today. Marie Angeles Hernandez. Love you. Mealy Lucas. Donna Lee. Love you. Anita Simmons. Just a few more, and then you're all excused. Jody Lawler. Love you. Anna H. I mean, you started from my first video and went all the way, and you commented almost on all of them and through my journey. I just adore you. Manny H., love you, love you, love you. And I'll see you soon, too. Rains, that's a cool name. Siddharth Thanker. Thanker. Sounds like foreign. Let me know where you're from, because that's definitely a different foreign name. PNW Terry. Love you. Lori in Revision. Wow, that's pretty cool. Weekend Nomad. Yay. Love you. And the last one, last but not least, is Erica, New York City, NYC. You know what, you guys? Don't go yet. You're not excused yet. I really appreciate you guys. Again, I want to say that you make my journey worthwhile here in my minivan. And I just appreciate you so much. And I know this is a long video. And thank you for watching all the way to the end. I really appreciate all of you. I love you guys. I mean, not like love. I mean, I'd have to meet you. But... In a human agape love, I really love all you guys. And you make my day. Every day when I look at your comments, you make my day. If I don't answer your comment right away, it's because I'm just looking through them, because I usually have things that I got to get going on. But I'm glad that I can spend maybe once a week just acknowledging you and commenting on you and putting you out there and sending love your way. So I do love all you guys. And I mean that. I'm gonna cry. You guys have a great week.